Now, let's take a look at the demo of how to do signal generation with Signal Studio Custom OFDM and the signal analysis with XApp VMA Custom OFDM. A Custom OFDM signal is comprised of a single repeating frame, where three different resource blocks could be included here: preambles, data, pilots. Each of these components takes up a section of time and the frequency, depending on the wireless communication standard being used. The standard also determines the number of symbols and the number of subcarriers in a single frame. Preamble and data blocks are distributed in time across different symbols, usually starting with preamble and followed by the data blocks, while pilots are distributed in frequency across different subcarriers, either in dedicated symbols or in the same symbols as the data. Let's get started. I'm going to start by opening up Signal Studio for custom modulation on my computer. This is connected to N51A2B MXG signal generator, which is located remotely from me. To actually generate the signal, let's get started on our waveform setup page over here. The first thing we need to do is pick the type of custom modulation that we would like to work with. Because this software supports three types, Custom IQ, Custom OFDM, and 5G candidates. For our purpose, let's pick Custom OFDM. And as you can see, this changed our available subpage to this Custom OFDM subpage. So let's click into that. As we can see, in OFDM settings, you can config FFT length, CP length, up-lower guard subcarriers, number of OFDM symbols. Signal Studio provides several standards format to you for quick setup. Let's pick WLAN A02.11A here. For OFDM resource allocation configuration, click Resource Mapping subpage. We can see user can easily define preamble, pilot, data allocation with symbol index, carrier index. Meanwhile, you can config each resource block modulation and IQ values or payload data as well. The selected resource allocation will be highlighted in the red color in the resource mapping diagram. Now, we have the basic knowledge of how to config these settings to create the OFDM signal. Next, let's record the YSON OFDM setup file prepared before to do this demo. As we can see, its resource allocation follows the standard frame structure. Press shortcut button here, and we will see dialogs telling us that the signal is being generated and downloaded. We are now ready to proceed to the analysis portion of this measurement and actually demodulate that custom OFDM signal that we just created. Let's look at how to get that done. I'm working with N9020B, a signal analyzer, which runs the Vector Modulation Analysis or VMA X-Series application that we'll be using for demodulation. This is a window-based instrument. It is located remotely from me, and because of that, I can use the IP address of the instrument and open a remote desktop session to it, and control it in that way. This is exactly what I've done here. So this is a display of the analyzer as viewed through the remote desktop. So let's switch into the Vector Modulation Analyzer mode. To do that, I click on the tab of the main tab to open up this mode measurement view selector screen. Scroll down through the list of modes and see Vector Modulation Analyzer. This offers several measurements to us, and because we are working with a custom OFDM, so we'll go with custom OFDM and keep the normal view. Now, we proceed to actually set up the signal that we want to demodulate. Here, VMA Custom OFDM measurement support to record Signal Studio Custom OFDM setup files, so we can press Record, select Demode Info tab, pick CC Setup as the data type, and select the setup files what we saved before. After recalling the Signal Studio setup file, the signal demodulated correctly with EVM 0.38% here. So from this example, we can see that Record Signal Studio Custom OFDM setup voice in VMA Custom OFDM is really powerful to you. All measurement parameters and settings will automatically be configured after recording a CP file. It saves your time to config these settings one by one manually. In Mass Time tab, mass interval is 40 symbols, which is same as Signal Studio OFDM symbols number. OFDM signal demodulation settings are all in the Demode tab. It covers FFT lengths, upper-lower guard subcarriers. XApp also provides resource mapping for allocation configuration along with the resource diagram. The selected resource will be highlighted in the red in the diagram, which has same behavior as Signal Studio Custom OFDM. What's more, it supports equalizer and tracking settings, advanced synchronization settings as well. Next, let's take a look at how to do resource allocation configuration here. XApp provides add, delete, clear, and modify options here for you to configure allocation. Let's take LTF section here. When we select the LTF allocation, its allocation in diagram is highlighted in red, which is same shown in the Signal Studio. Now we can click on the symbol index column to modify its symbol index value. Here we need to pay attention that apply button turns to yellow. It means there are modifications on the resource settings, but not applied to the resource diagram. Only after you press apply button, the modified allocation will be updated in the diagram. So now we can see LTF symbol index in diagram is changed from 4, 5 to only one symbol index is 4 here. In order to do further signal analysis, we change this back to the correct symbol index 4 and 5. Next, let's talk about another powerful feature. Fast Pilot and Preamble IQ data configuration. In Format tab, press Edit Pilot IQ values. XApp supports insert, modify, delete, quick search options for you here. For Preamble configuration, you can press Edit Preamble IQ values. Then same configuration options are available as well. XApp provides Record Pilot and Preamble IQ data files respectively. In order to demo this case, let's modify the first pilot Q data value from 0 to minus 1. Then in Signal Studio, let's save this pilot IQ values in the CSV file. Then we can see EVM is worse now. Now let's press Record, goes to the Demode Info tab, pick pilot IQ values, select the pilot data file saved before from the Signal Studio, press Record. After recording the pilot IQ data files, we can see the EVM is improved. Let's check the pilot IQ data demodulation settings here. So we can see the first Q data is modified to the original value 0, which means data recorded correctly. So this example shows you can utilize the function of recording pilot and preamble IQ data file to do the fast IQ data configuration rather than edit each IQ value manually. In order to improve troubleshooting efficiency, all measurement application related parameters and settings are saved as the state file. Meanwhile, with recording data is saved together with this state file. VMA Custom OFDM also supports this feature. You can easily record recording and state file to duplicate the issue offline without the measurement test what you did in the lab. Next, let's take a look at how to use these powerful tools to do faster troubleshooting. So let's get started. Press Record, select the recording under State tab, record the issued file here. After recording the issue file, the first thing we do is look at the error summary table. We notice that the value that most stands out from what we expected is the symbol clock error, which is fairly large. We also know that there's something wrong by simply looking at the constellation. In OFDM signals, there are many impairments that can cause a constellation to have this behavior. In order to get more information in time and the frequency domain, let's open error vector 3D trace. Moving along, we see that the error vector spectrum has a V-shaped, with the error getting larger as we go away from the center. Looking at the error vector time, we see that the error gets worse as we get further along in the measurement as well. Putting everything together, we know that we have an error that is frequency and time related. And we know that our symbol clock error is strange. The symbol clock error, in fact, can cause the behavior as we see in the time and the frequency domain. This means DUT has the clock drift. The reason is that in the V spectrum, we set the center of the spectrum as a reference point, and with the symbol clock arrow, the subcarrier spacing gets changed. As we go further away from the center, the spacing gets larger and larger. That's why there's a large arrow at the edge of the spectrum relative to the center. With EVM time, as we measure successful symbols, the clock arrow is getting bigger. This causes bigger arrows as they measure out in time. We can fix this by enabling timing tracking method. Let's go to the demodulation settings. Select equalizer and tracking. Turn on tracking time. The software can track symbol clock timing on a symbol by symbol basis based on what we measure from pilots. By enabling tracking timing, it's essentially taking what we have measured as our symbol clock arrow and correct space on that. Now we can see the EVM spectrum and EVM time trace are much cleaner. The constellation diagram and the EVM are both improved. In summary, the XAPP VMA application provides a comprehensive set of tools for demodulation and signal analysis. These tools enable you to measure and troubleshoot your DUT in different scenarios with confidence. To learn more and to download a free trial, visit us at these websites. Thanks for watching.